Apple just wrapped up WWDC, where they announced a ton of great features coming to iOS 16 and iPadOS 16. Today, we're gonna focus on a few features for the iPad, specifically Stage Manager and external display support. For the iPad Mini 6, the iPad Air 5, as well as the new iPad Pro. But we are gonna test those with the Studio Display, as well as LG's Ultrafine 5K. So we're gonna figure out what works, what doesn't, and where you'll be disappointed. Now, just so you and I are on the same page, this is not a review of iPadOS 16 Beta 1, but we're gonna look at the features that Apple's already discussed in the context of the iPad Mini 6, the iPad Air 5, and the 2021 iPad Pro. So that's how the features are gonna work, and we're gonna test that with compatibility on the Studio Display and LG's Ultrafine 5K. Now, a lot of people are rightfully upset that there's compatibility restrictions Apple's placing on which devices can be used with the external display when it's extended, as well as Stage Manager. Now, if you have an M1 iPad Pro or iPad Air, those devices should work. And if you have anything else, like if it's an A15, anything that has a A12X, A12Z, those will not work with that. And those experiences should be exactly what we see with the iPad Mini 6, which is gonna be our baseline test device. Now, this iPad is capable of delivering speeds 5 gigabits per second, which might be part of the reason why they don't have that extended display on that, but let's go ahead and find out. All right, we are plugging it in. Now we see here, display is up, and we are getting the same exact experience that we had prior to iPadOS 16. So here on the iPad Mini, it is full screen. Here on the Studio Display, it is at a 4:3 aspect ratio. There's the black bars. It looks ugly. Now, it does recognize here that the iPad Mini is the built-in display, shows the brightness. It does recognize that I have the Studio Display selected and that I can control auto brightness. I can control the brightness of the display, but there is no availability to mirror the display or to turn off mirroring, which we'll see here in just a few minutes. Any other iPad device, if it's not an M1, iPad Pro, iPad Air, you are gonna see the same 4:3 aspect ratio on your external display. Now let's check the LG Ultrafine 5K and see what happens here. Should be exactly the same, and it is, yeah. So same exact experience. We have the display. We see that there are two displays. It does detect the model display. That is done as well. The brightness is very high. Now, one of the new features that Apple talks about in iPadOS 16, and they talked about in the keynotes on their website, is display scaling, where you have the ability to scale down the display elements, including text, UI, to allow for more screen real estate on the device. Now, that is not available on this device here. We'll see it's gonna be available on the other devices that we test and come to that conclusion. Now, the next device I have here, this is the iPad Air 5. This is the one that just came out in this beautiful, beautiful blue color, which I am a huge fan of. This is 64 gigs of internal storage. This is Wi-Fi only, this version here. We're gonna plug it into the Studio Display. You see it there, it flashes for a second, like it goes through the process of detecting whether or not, like what model it is, I think. All right, so I have the display being extended here, and we see that here on the iPad, I have my home screen. Now I can move around from the home screen, and nothing changes on the secondary display. All right, now once I go to settings, let's go to display and brightness. We'll go to the built-in Retina display. That's this one right here. The brightness is configurable, the true tone configurable, display zoom. So we have standard and more space. So that is available on this device as well. If I click standard, you'll see that the display layer reboots. All right, and now all the UI elements are larger. Text size, built-in display. So we have standard, Studio Display. We have auto brightness. So the same configuration options. But now we see that we have the display zoom for more space turned on, and we can use standard, and that should only change it here, and use standard. Now you saw the dock just get bigger there, and let's change display zoom to zoomed, which sometimes it's nice to have. You zoomed, and the display got bigger, or sorry, the dock got bigger there. So that was one of the things that was not available on the iPad Mini 6, and it wouldn't be available on those other devices. And I imagine that is gonna be a function of the GPU that is on the M1 processor. So let's keep going here. So we display zoom. I'm gonna go back to standard on the Studio Display. And now we see here arrangement. So arrangement allows you to tell your device, where it's going to be positioned in context or in relation to the studio display. So when I'm moving my cursor up and down, that cursor then would go the right way. So now I'm going to, if I use my mouse and go to this way, there you go. You see the mouse coming in from the right-hand side of the studio display. We see that in the arrangement, there's even an option to mirror display. So when we change it to mirror, it changes the aspect ratio back to 4:3 with those black bars on the side, which I don't know why you would want this, but I can tell you that let's just turn off mirroring and we're gonna leave this as is. Now, one of the things that I do quite often is I take videos of my screen. I use screen recording. So now we're gonna turn that on and I have it right in control center because I use it so often, does the countdown. And now instead of screen recording two separate displays, it's only gonna screen record your one display in that 4:3 aspect ratio. So that's something that's maybe unexpected. I would think that it would maybe record two files in more, maybe you'll see that with maybe the M2 processor. I didn't think I would be able to change my wallpaper for one device. And in reality, what's probably being done here is that much like CarPlay, where Apple outputs or where your iPhone outputs a second display to the CarPlay display and it has a limited set of apps, that's probably what we're seeing some form of that here on the studio display. Now let's take a look here at Stage Manager. Now, so we're on the same page again. Stage Manager is a way of, I would say, organizing windows that can be used in a tile view on either your iPad or when you're using a secondary display. Now there is a shortcut that you can, that is here in the control center. We're gonna turn that on. And I think right now it's just a bug that this is happening. I think it reboots the display layer. That's what actually is going on because it only happens when you're connected to the secondary display. But again, this is not a review of the beta, so keep that in mind. So let's look here at Safari. And here you see that settings is in the Stage Manager, maybe it's like in the balcony. I'm trying to think what like the paradigm is, because a Stage Manager organizes and orchestrates a show, and that's kind of what Stage Manager is doing. This area that it's in here, I don't know what you would call that, but it's like maybe the waiting wing, or if you know anything about theater production, let me know. And I'm gonna take my note and just drag it on top. And now you see that these two windows are open side by side, and these windows, there are these handles here. These windows can be resized. And what is interesting to know that if you are used to resizing windows on a Mac, those windows resize very fluidly. And here they are limited to size classes. So these are all predetermined size classes. And it's a little bit jarring if you've used resizing of windows on the Mac and you come here to use it. So just keep that in mind. So here, if I have Notion up here on the secondary display and I want to view it on the primary display, if I go down to the dock and click it, it actually closes the window there and then opens it down here, which is really strange. It's just a kind of a weird experience. I don't think that's final. If you want to expose Stage Manager, there's a few different options here, and let's actually cover that real quick. So in Stage Manager, if you go down to the glyph, you can either have turn off Stage Manager, which is here at the bottom. You can hide the recent apps docs. You can show the recent apps and dock, or you can turn off the bottom dock. Let's show you how multitasking works on the iPad. Now I have the dock running in both places, which it should be. If I go to this dock up here, I have Notion, I have Todoist, and I can just click on these apps and they both come in and out of focus. Now let's just say I'm running the music app in full screen. If I just take my mouse cursor and I drag to the left, it shows me what is in Stage Manager. And you see that window goes to the side. Now let's just say I want to add a window here. It tells me to then choose what the window is. I'm gonna take my node. So now both these windows are running in this side-by-side mode. And these windows can be resized. If I wanted to, I should be able to add a third window up in here. All right, now I have this one. You see these windows are all kind of different sizes. Here, let's add one more. Test this here. I'm gonna unplug the studio display and I'm going to plug in the LG Ultrafine. So we could see here that we're getting the same experience. We have the LG Ultrafine 5K. We show the display, it's being extended. Let's see, can I see the windows? Notion, yeah. So it shows the same windows that were open. Continue. I wouldn't worry about this black screen for this app. I think that's just something that's going on right now. Yeah, there's not a clear way to send the, it's because I have four apps, that's why. So if I want to now, you can see a maximum of four apps. Oh, that's why. You can see a maximum of eight apps between your iPad and the secondary display at any one time. So let me close some of these. One of the things that you will not get on the iPad Air 5 is swap memory, unless you have the 256 gig version, which I can't imagine many people buy. But that's going to improve the performance, where it swaps out from the memory of the device, which I think right now is 6 gigs, if I'm not mistaken. And it's going to give you the ability to swap memory through 256 gigs of whatever is available in storage. Okay, so now all those apps are closed. So you can see it's actually a very comparable experience on the LG 5K and the studio display. Now let's check out the 2021 iPad Pro. So the very first time that you plug in your iPad, it does mirror the display in that 4:3 aspect ratio, but then after it's unlocked, give it a second, and then it does show up. Let's take a look here at the display and brightness. I'm in the right place. That's the normal way. Bold text. All right, built-in retina display. Display zoom. Here you have zoom, standard, and more space on the iPad itself. I'm gonna use more space. And you see here, that looks very clean. Studio display, I'm gonna do the same thing. Actually, it already is checked. So the iPad, even though it does support HDR, the external display does not. And I don't have, obviously, a Pro Display XDR, which does support HDR, but I would like to know how that works. So if you have that, let me know down in the comments below about that. Mirror display, these are all the same options. So that's good. Auto lock. So the display brightness on the iPad Pro is not working at the moment. I don't know why, but there is this icon in the top right-hand corner, which looks like the mirroring logo or the AirPlay logo. It's got a triangle around it. And normally what's been showing is that it's been too hot anytime that I use this. So let's close all these apps and see what happens. So now I'm gonna open up Notion here, full screen. I'm going to click on add app and I'm going to new tab. And so now we see that both these apps are open. If I resize this, it's that same kind of experience. So that's not necessarily based on the device itself. So we see that size classes are, it's being resized into windows based on size class. Now, if I wanna go to this window here, I'm gonna do it to see if I can get Stage Manager running on both devices at the same time. Turn on Stage Manager. And that same experience happened on the other device. Now that we have cancel Stage Manager running here, I'm gonna open up, add an app. Oops. And I'm going to open music. These are not in the FaceTime or they're not in the Stage Manager. Let's go back to Stage Manager. So I turned Stage Manager off. Now you see that these windows are back in the traditional multitasking context. So here I can just resize these windows dynamically. If I wanted to add another window here, I could say I want to open up Omni Outliner. And I could say I'm going to actually run this in Slide Over. And then I can have this app in Slide Over. So now I have these two apps open. But what is interesting is that for FaceTime, it doesn't actually take my camera. I don't know why that is. Let's see if we disconnect it. Does it recognize the camera then? Wait, hold on a second here. Let's move that over just a little bit. No, I thought I was gonna use my FaceTime camera from the studio display, and that's not the case. That's too bad. Oh, good, now it is recognizing my camera, and there's that silly, that's there. And here are the windows that are open on this device. So you can't run Stage Manager on your external display independently from that you have it on the built-in display or the iPad display, which is kind of silly. So if you run it one place, it does have to run it in both places. Let's open that up. And now that we have Stage Manager running, all right, so I have this open. Yep, that moves it here. So the multitasking glyphs, there is this swap display glyph. What if we change that if it would make it better? Let's find out. What I'm thinking is, if I go to settings and change, that's weird. Settings runs in maximized window mode in the middle. Let's go to display. It's probably because I have, display zoom more space. Let's see. I imagine that's just a weird kind of error. Oh, that's right. I'm going to go back to display and brightness. I'm going to go to arrangement. And if I click on move your iPad over here and click set. Oh, good. That does do it. Oh, wow. Okay. So that makes it a lot easier. So pro tip, if you have the iPad arrangement like this and your iPad is actually below it, you're gonna have trouble opening the dock on your secondary display. So if you have it opened, if you move the arrangement and have it positioned in a different way, but not physically change the positioning, you can then open the dock. Now, okay, I'm gonna click on here and remove, cool. All right, so now that is not there in the dock. And Notion was already paired with this Safari app. I'm gonna take this out and I'm gonna throw this to the side here. I'm gonna take this Notion app. I don't know why Notion's not working. Let's plug it into this display just to make sure things work as is, the expectation that it is. Yeah, it works exactly as you would expect. Let's turn on the brightness because that's gonna be super bright. So if I want to manage my windows, here we see the four different windows that are open on the iPad, but we don't see what's there on the secondary monitor. Now, if I unplug it, now we see that Notion is here. Here, let's check one more thing. So if I am wirelessly airplaying my display from my iPad mini to my Mac, it is gonna be limited to this 4:3 aspect ratio. It's actually, so you're not getting the full display resolution. It's not outputting it to a full display like it does when you're connected. So that is a little bit disappointing. In terms of the features, I would say that it is working as expected. It's not super polished. It's not smooth at all by any case. So don't upgrade to this unless you have nothing to do except for troubleshoot problems. I'm a little bit upset that the iPad mini does not work with Stage Manager. That was one of my expectations. I think I would like to have that. And as I just showed you a minute ago, if you AirPlay your display wirelessly to another Mac or to another display, you are gonna get that reduced resolution, that 4:3 resolution, because you're AirPlaying it, presumably because it's not wired connection, like from your monitor to the other display. You still can't use the camera from your studio display on your iPad. That would be something I would expect. Maybe that will come with continuity camera, who knows? But that would be a great option because I would love to not have this weird angle where someone is like looking up my nose during FaceTime or during Zoom calls. That would be great as well. But let me know what questions you have. My name is Mike. Thanks for tuning in. Guys, if you want to check out my WWDC video where I was at Apple Park, you can click right here in the card above. I'll talk to you in the next one.